Hi lovelies, so I wanted to show you a technique today using the Nuvo shimmer powders and some acetate. And there's two ways that you can do this to create a really beautiful sort of stained glass effect for cards and for other makes. So some acetate will have a film on one side, some will have a film on both sides. I tend to work with the side that hasn't got film on or the side that I take film off. So I leave the other side with the film on until this is dry. So I'm just going to take this off. And the first process is just using water. So all I'm going to do is come in and just spray water on that acetate. And then I'm going to start putting my powders down. This will work with the Nuvo shimmer powders and also cosmic shimmer powders as well. So this is meteorite shower from Nuvo. And I'm just going to come in and just tap the bottle. You don't need to squeeze it, you just tap it. And we can already see some of those colours starting to come out. I'm also going to add in a little bit of Lunar Rocket. And you can see the colour sort of getting trapped in little bubbles, which is something I love. And we're going to come in with a bit of Golden Sparkler. And then again, I'm just going to add some more water. And of course, the more water you add, the more of an effect you'll create. And I'm just going to add some of the solar flare in there as well. We're then just going to leave that to dry. And where it's puddled, it will evaporate. So it'll end up drying away. And you end up with a really gorgeous stained glass effect. Now, we haven't sealed this and we're not going to. So you can use this on projects that you're going to put this onto a backing. So for example, you can use it in a card as long as the surface has got a backing to it. If you want to create a more transparent effect using acetate and the shimmer powder, you need to use something to actually bind the powder. Once this is dry, it's not going anywhere, but you do end up with some powder residue. And if you want to, you can sort of have a play with moving things around because that will also affect the way that this dries. So you can either leave it as it is, or you can come in with a brush, or you can just kind of naturally let everything move around. So we've got a fresh piece of acetate and we're going to actually seal the shimmer powder so that when it's dry, you don't get any residue, so that if you want it as a cutout in a card, then you don't need anything for it to be backed onto. You want a clear drying glue. That's really important that we use a clear drying glue. So I'm just going to use some of the Cosmic Shimmer acrylic glue. And I'm just going to come in and sort of wave that all over. You can then go in with a paintbrush or you can just use your finger. And you're just going to smooth the glue all over the acetate. And take it right up to the edges. Of course, I would cut this. So I would come in once this is all dry and either hand cut it or cut it in the machine. So I've played with this method quite a lot. And there are some people that say you add your shimmer powder, then your water. I actually do my water on my glue before I add anything. So I'm going to spray my water all over. And of course, the amount of water that you spray on there will affect your end result. So I'm going to add some lilac waterfall to this. And again, you're just tapping, you're not squeezing. And straight away, we can see some of those colours starting to emerge. I'm going to add some solar flare. And a little bit of blue blitz. And then again, I can add my water. And I'm just going to add a little bit more of the lilac waterfall. And then again, we're just going to leave that to naturally dry. As I say, with the non-sealed version, you want to make sure that you do back it onto something, because you will be left with some residue. And if you're using white card, for example, that residue can transfer. If you don't want to back it, then you are going to want to be using the glue version of this. But you can create some beautiful, beautiful cards using this method. As always, thank you so much for watching. If you've got any comments or questions, please do ask below. Don't forget to subscribe, give the video a thumbs up, hit that notification bell, and I'll see you all again soon. Bye!